RJD Supremo Lalu Prasad Yadav has added fuel to the Muslim quota fire, saying Muslims should get full quota. The BJP jumped on the issue, insisting this proves opposition India Alliance members are out to deny the scheduled caste, the scheduled tribe and the OBCs their full quota and give it to their Muslim vote bank instead. The BJP said what had happened in Karnataka with Muslims getting 4% quota out of the OBC pie was only a trailer. And if the opposition India Alliance were to win these elections, then Baba Saheb Ambedkar's constitution would be changed for Muslim appeasement politics. Lalu Yadav was quick to issue a clarification, saying quota was not on the basis of religion, but social quota for social and caste realities. A political bureau with this report.
Reservations continue to reverberate on the campaign trail. RJD chief Lalu Prasad pushed for job quotas for Muslims.
आरक्षण के पक्षधर है ना वो तो संविधान को खत्म करना चाहते हैं, लोकतंत्र को खत्म करना चाहते हैं। ये इस बात को जनता के जहन में शायद बात आ गई है कि इस तरह की बात बदल रिजर्वेशन तो मिलना चाहिए मुसलमानों को।
Prime Minister Narendra Modi seized on Lalu Prasad's proposal, attacked the former Bihar Chief Minister in a stinging election speech.
उनके एक नेता जो चारा खाने के कारण जेल में है, अच्छा उन्होंने क्या कहा? ऐसे हाथ पछाड़ के बोल रहे हैं, मुसलमानों को आरक्षण मिलना चाहिए, और सिर्फ आरक्षण नहीं मिलना चाहिए, वो कहते हैं कि पूरा का पूरा आरक्षण मुसलमानों को मिलना चाहिए। इसका मतलब क्या हुआ? एससी एसटी ओबीसी समाज को जितना आरक्षण मिला है वो छीन कर ये लोग पूरा का पूरा आरक्षण मुसलमानों को देना चाहते हैं।
उत्तर प्रदेश चीफ मिनिस्टर इंटेंसिफाइड द पॉलिटिकल ऑफेंसिव, डिस्क्राइबिंग लालू प्रसाद्स रिमार्क्स एज अ प्राइम एग्जांपल ऑफ द ऑपोजिशंस अपीसमेंट पॉलिटिक्स।
बाबा साहब भीमराव अंबेडकर धर्म के आधार पर आरक्षण के विरोधी थे। उन्होंने कहा धर्म के आधार पर कोई आरक्षण नहीं हो सकता, लेकिन कांग्रेस को, समाजवादी पार्टी आरजेडी को जब भी अवसर मिलेगा ये अनुसूचित जाति जनजाति और पिछड़ी जाति के आरक्षण के अधिकार पर सेन लगा करके इन्हें जबरन अल्पसंख्यकों को देने का कुचित प्रयास करें।
As the BJP stepped up its onslaught, Lalu Prasad clarified his stance, asserting that job reservations are determined by social structure, not religion.
मंडल कमीशन मैंने लागू किया था, हम आरक्षण सामाजिक आधार होता है, धर्म आधार नहीं होता है। अटल बिहारी वाजपेयी जी ने संविधान समीक्षा आयोग बना दिया था।
द समाजवादी पार्टी मीनवाइल चैलेंज्ड द बीजेपी अगेन, रेजिंग कंसर्न्स ओवर रिजर्वेशंस फॉर इकोनॉमिकली डिसएडवांटेज्ड कम्युनिटीज।
जो आरक्षण की मूल भावना थी उससे खिलवाड़ हुई है। भारतीय जनता पार्टी और भारतीय जनता पार्टी के लोग कभी नहीं चाहते कि पिछड़े दलित आदिवासी हक सम्मान पाए, इसीलिए वो संविधान से छेड़खानी की तैयारी है। आप खुद जानते हैं कि जनरल में लोग पहुंच जाते थे, जनरल में क्यों नहीं अब पहुंच पा रहे पिछड़े और दलित तो आदिवासी? ये किसने पाबंदी लगाई, किसने रोका?
जॉब कोटर्स कंटिन्यू टू शेप द इलेक्टोरल लैंडस्केप विद द मुस्लिम फैक्टर इमर्जिंग एज अ पिवोटल फ्लैश पॉइंट। ब्यूरो रिपोर्ट, इंडिया टुडे।
Phase 3 of polling in Gujarat saw Prime Minister Narendra Modi cast his vote in Ahmedabad amidst chants of Modi, Modi and Bharat Mata Ki Jai outside the booth. He interacted with voters, posed for selfies, signed autographs. Union Home Minister Amit Shah, accompanied by his wife, son and daughter-in-law, also voted. He's a contender from Gandhinagar. Gujarat has been a BJP stronghold and here's how the state voted.
Gujarat has made its decision. The state voted on Tuesday in the third phase of Lok Sabha elections. Prime Minister Narendra Modi cast his vote at the Nishan Public School in Ahmedabad. Union Minister Amit Shah, contesting to retain the Gandhinagar Lok Sabha seat, accompanied Modi to the polling booth. The Prime Minister greeted people and signed autographs. He bowed down to his elder brother, Soma Bhai Modi, before entering the booth.
मैं देशवासियों को विशेष रूप से आग्रह करूंगा कि लोकतंत्र में मतदान एक सामान्य दान नहीं है। हमारे देश में दान का एक महत्व है और उसी भाव से देशवासी ज्यादा से ज्यादा मतदान करें।
After casting his vote, Modi interacted with children.
बहुत अच्छा लगा। हमारी लाइफ में हमने फर्स्ट टाइम इस तरह छूके, जैसे भगवान को साक्षात जैसे दर्शन हुए हो ऐसा लगा।
वो ऐसे खुद ऐसा चलकर आए और मुझे ऑटोग्राफ दिया। मैं इतनी खुश थी कि मैं सिर्फ उन्हें ही देख रही थी, वो मेरे स्केच पर उनका ऑटोग्राफ देख रहे थे।
Union Minister Amit Shah, accompanied by his son Jay Shah, exercised his voting right in Ahmedabad. Shah greeted citizens after voting. The Home Minister visited a nearby temple with his family, a tradition he observes every voting day.
मैं देश भर के सभी मतदाताओं को और गुजरात के मतदाताओं को भी मन से विनंती करना चाहता हूं कि बढ़ चढ़कर लोकतंत्र के इस महोत्सव में हिस्सा ले।
इंडस्ट्रियलिस्ट गौतम अदानी आल्सो कास्ट हिज वोट इन अहमदाबाद। उत्तर प्रदेश गवर्नर आनंदीबेन पटेल, गुजरात चीफ मिनिस्टर भूपेंद्र पटेल, यूनियन मिनिस्टर मनसुख मंडाविया, एमएलए रिबाबा जडेजा वर अमंग दोज हु एक्सरसाइज देयर फ्रेंचाइज। ब्यूरो रिपोर्ट, इंडिया टुडे।
14 Lok Sabha constituencies in Karnataka also went to polls in phase 3. Votes were cast in North Karnataka. Now, all 14 seats were swept by the BJP in 2019. This time, votes were cast in the shadow of the Rivanna sex abuse case. We bring you more from Ground Zero.
The last leg of polls in Karnataka took place on Tuesday amid a searing heat wave. With this, voting in all 28 parliament seats in the state is completed. Former Chief Minister and senior BJP leader B.S. Yediyurappa cast his vote in Shivamoga along with his sons B.Y. Vijendra, the state BJP chief, and B.Y. Raghavendra, the sitting MP and candidate from the constituency.
100% will do very good performance in this election. Pro-incumbency is here. So, very good in our party will be.
The spirit of the people is pretty clear. The people of this state wants Narendra Modi ji as the Prime Minister of this country. Irrespective of Congress government here in the state, irrespective of people voting Congress party in the last assembly election, but this as parliamentary election, the people of the state will bless Bharatiya Janata Party once again.
We are going to win 24-25 seats. I got that confidence. And wherever we go, Modi, that because of that reason, we are going to win minimum 24-25 seats this time also.
Former BJP Minister Ishwarappa, who rebelled against the party after his son was overlooked for a ticket, is contesting as an independent candidate from Shivamoga. Former Chief Minister Basavraj Bommai cast his vote in Haveri.
We have casted your vote also. So how is the winning prospect for BJP in this third phase of election?
No, today is a voting day, celebration of democracy. So I request everybody to come out, brave the heat. Come out and vote and be a part of the celebration and make democracy successful.
About the political storm that has raked up the Karnataka in the second and third phase, sir, involving Prajwal Revanna.
See, that is not, I should not say anything, Baba, today. It goes against the law.
While Hubli Dharwad candidate and Union Minister Prahlad Joshi cast his vote in Hubli city, former Chief Minister Jagdish Shettar did so in Belagavi.
Our Prime Minister candidate is Narendra Modi. Under his leadership, we are fighting the election. What is the Congress leadership? Who is the Prime Minister?
You will be briefly with the Congress. Do you think Siddaramaiah is a face to reckon with?
No,
or D.K. Shivkumar, are they good leaders?
No, that is not at all issue here in the election. It is a parliament election. National level, who is the Prime Minister candidate for the Congress? Congress is a leaderless party.
Congress President Mallikarjun Kharge and his son Priyank Kharge exercised their franchise in Kalaburgi.
चुनाव तो यहाँ पर अच्छा है, माहौल भी अच्छा है. इस बार कांग्रेस पार्टी को भारी बहुमत मिलेगा और इस बार एक होके सभी लोग कांग्रेस को जिताएंगे.
आप मुझे बताइए.
वेलफेयर गारंटीज ऑफ प्राइम मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी एंड चीफ मिनिस्टर सिद्धरमैया, रिजर्वेशन, हुबली नेहा हीरामत मर्डर केस एंड द प्रज्वल रेवन्ना सेक्स गेट वर द टॉप इलेक्शन इश्यूज इन कर्नाटका.
द बिग क्वेश्चन दिस टाइम is will the BJP be able to maintain its vote share and maintain the lion's share of seats that it won last time, and will the Congress be able to make the cut this time and win more number of seats is the one to be watched out for. But camera person Madhuar, Anaga Keshav reporting for India Today from Bangalore.
We will continue to track these political developments very closely, but that is all I have for you on this broadcast. Many thanks for watching. News and updates continue on India Today. Stay with us.